We're going to look at some examples of factoring. We're going to start with factor 9x squared minus 49y to the fourth. This falls into the form difference of squares. What we have to do here is figure out what are the two things being squared. Well, 9x squared is 3x times 3x, so 9x squared is 3x quantity squared. 49y to the fourth is 7y squared times 7y squared, so this is 7y squared quantity squared. So we can rewrite a squared minus b squared as a plus b times a minus b. In this case, our a is 3x and our b is 7y squared. So we get 3x plus 7y squared times 3x minus 7y squared. Now let's look at factoring x squared minus 2x minus 120. This is a factorization of a simple trinomial with leading coefficient 1. And all we have to do is find two numbers that add up to the middle coefficient, negative 2, but multiply out to our third number, negative 120. And those two numbers are 2 apart, and they happen to be 10 and negative 12, because 10 plus negative 12 is negative 2. 10 times negative 12 is negative 120. So our factorization is going to be x plus our first number, which is x plus 10, times x plus our second number, x plus negative 12. But we would write that as x plus 10 times x minus 12. Okay, now we're going to factor another trinomial that does not have a leading coefficient of 1. Our trinomial is 2x squared plus 3x minus 14. And we're going to use the method of listing and checking all the possibilities of binomial products that give us the leading term 2x squared and the third term negative 14. And we're going to check each possibility to see if we get 3x's. So we list all these possibilities, and our first possibility is 2x minus 2 times x plus 7. That gives us the 2x squared. It also gives us the minus 14. But the middle products are 14x and minus 2x, and those add up to 12x's. And that doesn't work because we want 3x's. Then we check 2x minus 7 times x plus 2. This also gives us 2x squared, and it gives us minus 14. But the middle products, 4x and negative 7x, add up to negative 3x, which again does not work. We again check 2x plus 2 and x minus 7. This gives us 2x squared and negative 14. But the middle products are negative 14x and plus 2x, and that gives us negative 12x. Finally, we try 2x plus 7 times x minus 2. This gives us 2x squared. This also gives us minus 14 when we multiply it out. And the negative 4x and the plus 7x adds up to 3x, which is what we want. So this last possibility of 2x plus 7 times x minus 2 is the one that works. Now, there were some more possible combinations that could have used a negative 1 and a 14. And one of the possibilities was 2x minus 1 times x plus 14. Now, I didn't even list these because the 14 is going to give us just way too many x's, either positive or negative. And a lot of times you can just see that certain possibilities just aren't going to work. They're just not going to give you the number of x's you want. So once you get good at doing these, you can bypass a lot of the extra possibilities that do not work. Okay, we're going to look at the next problem. Factor 2x squared minus 2x minus 84. This looks like the one we just did, but it's a little bit different. In this case, there's a common factor of 2, and we can factor that 2 out of all the terms, and we get 2 times x squared minus x minus 42. Now we have a trinomial like one of the previous examples with the leading coefficient 1, and we just have to find two numbers that add up to the middle coefficient, negative 1, and multiply out to negative 42. And those two numbers are negative 7 and positive 6, so our factorization will be x minus 7 times x plus 6 times that leading coefficient we factored out. So our answer here is 2 times the quantity x minus 7 times x plus 6. Now we're going to look at an example where we factor an expression by grouping. We're going to factor 2x squared minus 3y minus 6x plus xy by grouping. The first thing you want to do here is form two groups that have common factors. Well, 2x squared and 3y don't have a common factor, but 2x squared and xy both have the factor x. So I'm going to group those together as one group, 2x squared plus xy. Then I'm going to group the negative 3y and negative 6x together. And look at what I've done here. I've changed all the subtractions into additions of the negatives. Now you're going to see why this is helpful. So I rewrote this as 2x squared plus xy plus negative 3y plus negative 6x. Now factor out the common factors. In that first group, we can factor an x out, and we get x times 2x plus y. In the second group, we can factor a negative 3 out, and we get negative 3 times y plus 2x, because negative 3 times y is negative 3y. Negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. And now we identify the common factor within parentheses. Well, we see we have a 2x plus y and a y plus 2x. Well, we could really write the 2x plus y, or the y plus 2x, as 2x plus y. And also, I can write this plus negative 3 now as just minus 3. So I can rewrite this as x times 2x plus y minus 3 times 2x plus y. Now I can factor that 2x plus y term out in front, and it's times x, and it's times minus 3. So we get 2x plus y times x minus 3.